Hi, I'm Bill Griffith, an application engineer from Agilent Technologies, and today we're going to talk about AC measurements. Most modern multimeters use a true RMS technique for measuring AC voltage. The advantage of using true RMS is that it measures the energy in the signal regardless of the shape of the signal. So as an example, one type of true RMS converter is a thermal converter. So what it does is it takes the signal, converts it to heat, and then measures the temperature. This technique is still used in RF and microwave power meters. Most modern multimeters use an analog technique, such as our 34401 multimeter. Our newest multimeter, the 34410A and 34411A, use a digital technique for measuring true RMS. So a couple of considerations with our multimeter when making AC measurements. The first one is going to be amplitude. If you put in a large AC signal, a couple hundred volts, what you'll see is self-heating of the multimeter and you'll have additional errors. And that's true with all multimeters. Another consideration is when you're measuring small AC voltages, oftentimes you'll see people shorting their leads together. And really that has no meaning when you're using an AC measurement. The reason for this is all true RMS converters have a range in which they work. So in the case of the 34401 with its analog converter, it can go down to 5% of its range, which is 5 millivolts. And the 3410 and 11A with its digital true RMS converter, it can actually go down to 1 millivolt or 0.3% of its lowest range. So it has a lot more dynamic range than the analog converter. The next consideration is frequency. So I'm actually putting in a fairly high frequency into this multimeter at this time. It's a 200 kilohertz signal. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to start increasing the frequency on it. And as I increase the frequency, what you'll see is you'll see the amplitude will start to roll off. And that's common with all true RMS multimeters. Both of these multimeters tend to roll off around 300 kilohertz. So on the other end of frequency, we can go to the low end. So I have a low frequency signal set up on my other channel of my function generator. And so I have it set to 20 hertz right now. And so as I start to reduce the frequency, you'll start to see the measurement will start to jump around, and eventually it becomes inaccurate. So what we have is we have three filters for our AC measurement, and this is true with both multimeters. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to pick a slow filter so that it has time to look at the entire duty cycle of that AC waveform. And as you can see, it's now reading very stable. So the trade-off is speed versus the ability to look over the entire AC waveform. The next consideration I'd like to look at is if you have a DC offset. So I'm going to go back to my higher frequency signal that we had earlier. And I have a DC offset in this signal. And so as you can see, we can measure the AC component. And then when we switch to our DC, you can see that there's a DC component to the signal as well. And so if you want to figure out the combined energy in the two signals, you can use the sum of squares. So that means you take your DC voltage, you square it, you take your AC voltage, you square it, you add them together, and then you take the square root of it to get the total energy in the signal when there's a DC offset. The final consideration is when you're measuring pulse type waveforms or waveforms of odd shapes. What they'll tend to have is they'll tend to have a high peak value, and then they'll have a lower average or RMS value. That is referred to as a crest factor, that ratio. And so signals that have a high crest factor can be difficult to measure. So on our analog multimeter, we can measure signals with up to a 5-to-1 crest factor, whereas with using a digital technique, we can actually measure signals with a 10-to-1 crest factor. So a big improvement on the ability to measure pulse type signals with a new digital multimeter. Modern AC signals are complex. Switching power supplies have high frequency, digital communication signals have high crest factors, and power supplies and circuits designed to save power will often turn off parts of them creating a long duty cycle in your AC waveform. For these reasons, we've chose to use a digital true RMS converter in our new 34410A and 11A multimeter. So these are some of the considerations while you're making your AC measurements. I hope you find them useful. Thanks for watching.